Hello children, welcome to our English class. Here we are reading the story of ikat, session 2, reading section. I hope you enjoyed the first part. Let's recap the previous session. Here social studies teacher Janaki entered the class with brilliant red-black checked remarks, shawls with black and blue geometric patterns with her, which made the class vibrant. She wrote on the blackboard, "Textile of India, ikat of AP," and pronounced the word ikat means to bind or knot. And she began to explain the story of ikat. Children, let's see how the ikat material is woven by weavers in this coming short video.
Ikat dyeing is unique in that the threads are first dyed through a resist process, and then those threads are hand woven. This process involves stretching the threads out 10 meters long through the length of a weaving house. The master designer draws lines across the yarn to indicate the design. Rubber bindings are placed on the yarn according to the markings. These bindings will resist the dye. The yarn is then dyed with the initial base color and dried in the sun. The bindings are removed, and if a second or third color is used, then the first steps will be repeated. Once the yarn is completely dyed, the yarn is placed on the loom and woven by either a hand or power loom.
Children, let's see the glossary part. Expectantly, which is adverb, means hopeful of something. Intersect, it's a verb, means crossing each other with a point. Jubilant, it's nothing but adjective, meaning very happy. Headgear, a piece of cloth worn on head. Children, let's see some more words. Resolve means solve. Knot means fastening. Vibrant, active. Compelling, extremely interesting. Here you can see a picture of a knot. Pattern, design used as a guide in needlework and other crafts. Motif, a decorative image or design, especially a repeated one forming a pattern. Fabric, fabric means cloth produced by weaving or knitting textile fibers. Export, send goods or services to another country for sale. Dye, add a color to or change the color of by soaking it in a solution impregnated with a dye. Sacred, connected with God. Children, let's see what is meant by dyeing in a small video. What? The threads on a loom over and under which other threads are passed to make cloth. Weft, the crosswise threads on a loom that are passed over and under the warp threads to make cloth. Children, let us move to the reading section. The teacher said, "Are you thinking about the word ikat or word tie and dye while you are looking at the fabrics? What can be the origin of the word?" No one answered, but what can be the origin of the word? Looked expectantly as she continued. In hand weaving, we have threads stretched lengthwise curl warp and threads intersecting them with widthwise curl weft. Imagine the graph sheet and the x-axis and the y-axis and how they crisscross to form square motif. Ahmed was excited. Teacher, what is stretched along y-axis and wrapped along x-axis? The class was thrilled as a new understanding came. Janaki said, in ikat, the threads are carefully sorted, warped and weft divided into bundles, then tied with locally available waterproof materials like plastic sheets, rubber strips from car and bicycle tires, then dropped into color. Once you unite the knots, you can see white threads dotted with color at intervals. Ravi said, teacher, how do they know where to tie the knots? Janaki smiled. The ties indicate the design we want. We can look at the design or a motif and a tie. Ravi looked puzzled. It did not seem simple. Ravi, you are absolutely right, the teacher said. It is not easy. First you count the threads, measure the distance, calculate when to repeat a pattern. Only then you can tie the knots. Teacher, it seems like difficult maths, Ramya said. Correct. Weavers may not be formally educated, but have complex calculations at their fingertips. They draw patterns on the graphs and copy them on the threads, Janaki continued. Just close your eyes and imagine threads stretched out along with dots of different colors shining. I have seen such a sight in villages of Nalgonda, someone said. Teacher, the dots are like raindrops. Chukka, that is how the name Chitki Rumon. This was the favorite headgear of fishermen and other laborers. It was also the towel on the shoulders of traders in Gujarat. She suddenly thought of another explanation. She asked, children, when you have to measure a small quantity of a material, you use a specific word in Telugu. This time Ramya answered promptly, Chitikeru. And before she completed, comprehension was written large on every child's face. Teacher, Chitiki means small and small dots of color which are characteristic of ikat. They chorused. The class was jubilant. They were able to come up with an original explanation for a historical phrase. When trade was vigorous with the other nations in Southeast Asia, tie and dye or chitiki as lengths of fabric was a favorite export item both in silk and cotton, she said. There are other interesting stories on ikat. Different regions fight about its origin. Did it travel from Gujarat to the south or vice versa? Did it first originate in the coastal belt of Andhra Pradesh and travel to Nalgonda? There is no systematic historical documentation to resolve this dispute. The class was fully attentive now. For Raksha Bandhan, the tying of the knot was done by yellow and red ikat tied threads. In our tradition, tying the knot is sacred. Maybe this has a relation to tying and dyeing process. But in parts of Gujarat, Maharashtra and Dakhan, designs in ikat were very much influenced by Muslim culture. The bell was ringing and the class was lost in a period where vibrant colors and compelling stories were woven into beautiful fabrics. Dr. B. Shyamasundari. Children, now it's time to know the opposites of difficult words given in the textbook. Antonyms. In hand weaving, we have stretched lengthwise called warp. The underlined word is stretched. So, let us know the opposite of that stretched. Opposite of stretched is shortened or contract. You see, you use a specific word in Telugu. The underlined word here is specific. Let's know what is the opposite of specific. It's general. The class was jubilant. The class was jubilant. What is the opposite of jubilant? Opposite of jubilant is gloomy or unhappy. Let us see some more words. When trade was vigorous with other nations in Southeast Asia, tie and dye are chitiki. The underlined word is vigorous. What is the opposite of vigorous here? Inactive or dull. Vigorous opposite is inactive or dull. Let's move to the another word. Lengths of fabric was a favorite export item both in silk and cotton. The underlined word here is export. The opposite of export is here import. Export opposite is import. There is no systematic historical documentation to resolve this dispute. There is no systematic historical documentation to resolve this dispute. The underlined word here is resolve and dispute. Now, first let's know the opposite of resolve. Opposite of resolve is complaint. Let's go to the word dispute. What is the opposite of dispute here? Agreement. Dispute, agreement, resolve, complaint. Here are some more words to learn the opposites. The class was fully attentive now. The underlined word here is attentive. What is the opposite of attentive? Opposite of attentive is distract or sometimes inattentive. Let's move to the next sentence. The bell was ringing, but the class was lost in a period where vibrant colors and compelling stories were woven into beautiful fabrics. What are the underlying words here? Compel and vibrant. Compel and vibrant. Let's know the opposite of compel first. Opposite of compel is stop. Opposite of compel is stop. Then go to the vibrant. Opposite of vibrant is dull. So, opposite of vibrant is dull. Let's move to the another section, that is comprehension, question and answers. Let's move to the first question. How was chikki rumal used by different people? Chikki rumal was used as a case of fisherman. Jowl on the shoulders of traders in Gujarat. Let's move to the second question. How can you say the rivers have complex calculations? The answer would be like this. We count the threads and calculate when the repeated patterns. Only then they will tie the knots. They draw the patterns on the graphs and copy them on the threads. Let's see the third question. The writer described some designs, historical things, and the weaving. Which part of the story do you like most? The answer would be like this. I like the way of tying and dyeing crosses while weaving the ikat sari. I love designs of ikat saris. The fourth question. Would you like to support our weavers? Explain how. Yes, I would like to support them by buying a handmade material woven by our weavers. I hope you come to know how hard it would be to weave with the sarees. So children, whenever you visit exhibitions or tourist places, try to convince your parents to buy such valuable handloom materials. This would be helpful to them for their survival. Thank you very much for watching this video.